Next, you'll want to prepare an outline. And it doesn't really matter what kind of a format you choose. You can choose a traditional outline format. Some people like to do a sentence outline format where the sentences are the opening parts of your paper. And others like to use a mapping format where they take different concepts and try to link those together. Use whatever works for you, but I encourage you that making an outline and laying out the paper ahead of time is an essential part of writing. You want to know ahead of time, what are your major headings? What is the flow of your paper, the organization of your paper? And it'll help you know if your paper is going to be within the page limits of that manuscript. As you prepare the outline, again, look at how others have prepared the topic. What I do when I write is I often get maybe 5 key articles that are similar to my topic, and I see how other authors have organized the topic. Because sometimes when you write, you get stuck. What comes first, the chicken or the egg? And you almost get stuck because you can't figure out what part to put first. So look at how others have tackled the topic. You'll get some cues from others when you outline their paper and then begin to make your own outline. So you'll create your own tentative outline that will guide you as you write. As you write, you may need to change that outline, and that's okay, but it's your starting point. It's important in journal articles as you're making your outline to think about what content you'll put into tables, what figures you'll gather. The difference between term paper writing and journal article writing is that journal articles usually contain tables or figures, some kind of boxes with summary comments, and that's important. It's helpful in a journal article, for example, if you create a table where you can put in a lot of content that you don't need to repeat actually in the text. For example, you could have a table with symptoms, and the second column could be the physiologic rationale for those symptoms. And then in the text of the paper, you could merely refer the reader to the table. You don't have to re-explain everything that's in your table.